The study of unidentified aerial phenomena has recently picked up again after a frightening discovery was made by the International Space Station Tracker. The tracker, which provides an uninterrupted video feed of Earth from space, suddenly went down after capturing an object that left observers terrified. Let's take a closer look. Discussion of unidentified flying objects, or as they have recently been rebranded, unidentified aerial phenomena, was long relegated to society's fringes. The topic was toxic, and many people avoided serious engagement with it out of fear of being branded a crackpot. But that has begun to change in the past few years. Prominent scientists now openly push for a serious study of UFOs, and the U.S. Navy recently drew up new guidelines that encourage pilots to report curious or confusing sky sights. People have seen intriguing or confounding objects in the sky for as long as we've been looking up. Over the eons, for example, many different cultures have regarded meteors and comets as supernatural phenomena, or at least processed them through a supernatural lens. These dramatic skylights have been deemed manifestations of a deity's displeasure or interpreted as signs that something wonderful, terrible, or simply consequential is soon to happen. The UFO phenomenon as we know it today is much more recent, dating to the era of powered flight. The first sightings started during World War II when Allied pilots in both the European and Pacific theaters reported seeing puzzling lights or objects in the sky. They called these curiosities Foo Fighters. Then, in June 1947, American businessman and aviator Kenneth Arnold reported seeing 9 shiny, mysterious crafts zipping through the skies near Washington's Mount Rainier. Some newspaper stories describe these UFOs as flying discs or flying saucers, and the latter term soon wormed its way into the public consciousness. UFO reports surged in the wake of Arnold's sighting, some of them even winding up in the pages of the New York Times. One of the items the Times picked up was the discovery of some seemingly exotic wreckage on a ranch in Lincoln County, New Mexico in 1947. In July of that year, a public information officer at the nearby Roswell Army Airfield described the debris as a flying disc, briefly igniting a firestorm of confused interest. Army officials quickly retracted that statement, explaining that the material in question was the remains of a crashed weather balloon, and the Roswell incident faded into obscurity. The U.S. military, concerned that some of these UFOs might pose a threat to national security, soon began to investigate sightings systematically. The more well-known Project Blue Book got started in 1952 and ran until 1969, examining more than 12,600 UFO reports along the way. One of the sightings Project Blue Book investigated was that of Betty and Barney Hill, who claimed they were captured and examined by extraterrestrials in rural New Hampshire in September 1961. The couple's accounts started getting picked up by newspapers in 1965, becoming the first ever widely publicized alien abduction story. UFO sightings didn't end when Project Blue Book wrapped up. Of course, they've kept on rolling in over the decades. Some of the most famous ones in the past half century include that of Travis Walton, an Arizona man whose 1975 alien abduction claim was dramatized in the 1993 film Fire in the Sky, the Rendlesham Forest incident, a string of mysterious observations near England's Royal Air Force Woodbridge Station in December 1980, and the Phoenix Lights, which confused many Arizonans in March 1997. And in November of 2004, several U.S. Navy pilots flying off the coast of San Diego reported seeing bizarre craft zooming through the sky, seemingly maneuvering in ways that exceeded the limits of known technology. Other Navy pilots had similar experiences off the U.S. East Coast a decade later, making a series of intriguing observations from June 2014 to March 2015. The pilots captured infrared video of some of these encounters using their onboard camera systems. 3 of these videos went viral in December 2017 when the New York Times published them as part of a blockbuster story about a previously secret military UFO investigating effort called the Advanced Aerospace Threat Identification Program, or ATIP for short. The program ran from 2007 until a funding phase out in 2012. UFOs are undeniably real. People often see things in the sky that they can't identify. But that doesn't necessarily mean that there's anything exotic going on. For example, the 1947 Roswell debris actually came from a high-altitude balloon lofted by the U.S. military as part of Project Mogul, a secret program that searched for evidence of atomic bomb tests by the Soviet Union. And the 1997 Phoenix Lights were likely caused by high-flying planes and a military flare-dropping exercise. Alien abduction stories are more complicated, as they tend to involve more psychological components. Project Blue Book got to the bottom of the vast majority of the 12,600 sightings it investigated, ascribing most of them to natural phenomena such as clouds, stars, and bright planets. The Air Force researchers could not explain 701 of the encounters, but they concluded that none displayed evidence of otherworldly technology or posed a threat to national security. Still, the ET idea should not be dismissed or ridiculed, as some sightings remain unexplained. One such sighting was made by the International Space Station. The International Space Station is a multi-nation construction project that is the largest single structure humans ever put into space. Its main construction was completed between 1998 and 2011, although the station has continually evolved to include new missions and experiments. It has been continuously occupied since November 2, 2000. According to the European Space Agency, the ISS is not owned by one single nation, and it is a cooperative program between Europe, the United States, Russia, Canada, and Japan. The space station costs about $3 billion per year for NASA to operate, roughly a third of the human spaceflight budget. As of May 2022, 258 individuals from 20 countries have visited the station. The top participating countries include the United States and Russia. Astronaut time and research time on the space station are allocated to space agencies according to how much money or resources they contribute. The ISS includes contributions from 15 nations. NASA, Roscosmos, and the European Space Agency are the major partners of the space station and contribute most of the funding. The other partners are the Japanese Aerospace Exploration Agency and the Canadian Space Agency. Current plans call for the space station to be operated through at least 2024, with the partners discussing a possible extension. NASA has approved an extension to 2030, although Russia says it'll withdraw after 2024 to focus on building its own space station around 2028. How the station will be operated after Russia's departure has not yet been determined. Crews aboard the ISS are assisted by mission control centers in Houston and Moscow, and a payload control center in Huntsville, Alabama. Other international mission control centers support the space station from Japan, Canada, and Europe. Elements of the ISS are controlled by mission control centers in Houston or Moscow. There is typically an international crew of 7 people that live and work inside the ISS. However, during the changeover of crew members, this number can vary. For example, in 2009, 13 crew members visited the ISS. This is also the record for the most people in space at one time. Occasionally, private missions such as those from Axiom Space bring non-professional astronauts on board the space station. Typically, astronauts travel to the space station via SpaceX's Crew Dragon capsule, or in the case of Russian cosmonauts, a Russian Soyuz capsule. The Soyuz was the primary form of transportation for all astronauts and cosmonauts after NASA's space shuttle program retired in 2011. Crew Dragon began flying people starting with the Demo 2 mission that launched on May 30, 2020. Boeing Starliner is preparing for launching humans after its successful uncrewed orbital flight test in 2022. Once at the station, astronauts will typically spend a mission period of around 6 months conducting various science experiments and maintaining and repairing the ISS. Outside of work, astronauts will spend at least 2 hours on exercise and personal care. They also occasionally perform spacewalks, conduct media or school events for outreach, and post updates to social media. The ISS is a platform for long-term research for human health, which NASA bills as a key stepping stone to letting humans explore other solar system destinations, such as the Moon or Mars. Human bodies change in microgravity, including alterations to muscles, bones, the cardiovascular system, and the eyes. Many scientific investigations are trying to characterize how severe the changes are and whether they can be reversed. Astronauts also participate in testing out products, such as an espresso machine or 3D printers, or doing biological experiments such as on rodents or plants, which the astronauts can grow and sometimes eat in space. As the only microgravity laboratory in existence, the ISS has facilitated more than 3,600 researchers to conduct more than 2,500 experiments to date. The station is in orbit around the Earth at an average altitude of 248 miles. It circles the globe every 90 minutes at a speed of about 17,500 miles. In one day, the station travels about the distance it would take to go from Earth to the Moon and back. At night, the station is highly visible from Earth, appearing as a luminous moving point of light and rivaling Venus in brightness. It can be easily seen from Earth without the use of a telescope by night sky observers who know when and where to look. The ISS is a constant source of intrigue for everyone on Earth, with many enthusiasts constantly tracking its location in space. UFO spotters have raised the alarm after the International Space Station live feed was cut out just as a large mysterious object appeared to enter Earth's atmosphere. The incident occurred on July 9, 2016, and was first reported by a UFO enthusiast in a video uploaded the same day. However, the observer did not directly imply that the object was an alien spacecraft, stating that it could well be a meteor or something alike. However, he did imply that the video feed turning off was slightly sinister. Observers state that it is interesting that the video feed cut off when the UFO seemed to stop. Other enthusiasts put forward different theories, including one who suggested it could be the Chinese space cargo ship Tiangong-1. This is not the first time that UFO hunters have accused NASA of cutting transmission after a mysterious UFO appeared on a live ISS stream. A NASA spokesperson made a statement earlier denying allegations that NASA technicians deliberately shut down transmission when UFOs appear on the live video. According to the spokesperson, NASA never intentionally shuts down live transmission to hide UFOs. Loss of video is usually due to a loss of signals from the ISS. However, observers around the world are not convinced by this statement. As interest in these mysterious phenomena increases, so does the need for more concrete answers. If you found this video interesting, you may also like this one, which talks about the Voyager and a worrying signal that the probe has sent back to Earth. Do you think the mysterious object detected by the ISS was a UAP? Please share your thoughts in the comment section below.